He promised 5,000 years ago in the Bhagavad Gita. According to the promise, he came down as Buddha. According to the promise, he came down as Christ. And he is working through the humanity. And we still expect that he comes down once again according to his promise. But no doubt he comes down, but not according to our expectations, but according to his plan. We have to understand his plan. We should not boast of promising for him. So let us try to understand why and how he comes. How he establishes the law once again among us. And a boy was brought and brought up, and it was prophesied that the Lord comes down through the boy once again. And every time we speak of the Lord coming down, and every time we speak of the world crisis, these two aspects have become the mental symptoms of the human race. It has become an obsession to speak of the world crisis, and humanity is speaking of the nasty world crisis since thousands of years. Even today we speak of the world crisis, and there are people who shout that the world is going into destruction. Take care. If at all it were to be true, what care you can take? If the world is going to destruction, there is no care which you and I can take. So let us not be foolish to imagine all sorts of nonsensical things. Let us be sensible and practical to understand the teachings of the Lord. Whenever he comes down, he has come down many hundreds of times till now. Some of the comings we know, some of the comings we do not know. And what all he wants to teach us, he has already taught through his previous comings. There is nothing new or very, very dazzling and important still to teach. There is nothing for him to teach still. There is everything for us to practice. He has taught and taught and taught. We are waiting and waiting before we can practice. This is the situation. And if at all the Lord comes down into humanity, it is only in the form of humanity and not an individual. So in the present age, a spiritual event takes place, and wherever there is service motive, wherever there is compassion and love, wherever there is spirit of cooperation, there is the presence automatically of the Lord. So he comes down in the form of groups of humanity, and he never proposes to come down for the present in an individual body. That is what the masters of wisdom promises, and the Lord waits until we are prepared to receive him. And if one individual is prepared, the Lord will be with him. If a group of 10 people are prepared, he lives as that group. And if 10 groups, such groups exist, he exists in the form of those 10 groups. And if 1,000 groups begin to exist, he simultaneously exists in the form of the 1,000 groups. And he proposes the network to take place. And it is in this way he is going to descend once again into humanity. And let us be prepared to receive him, instead of sleeping after he comes down. This is what he indicates in the present age. We are given the responsibility of preparing ourselves. Whereas in the past ages, the masters prepared disciples, and they used to impose rigorous discipline upon the disciples, and sometimes they used to punish the disciples also. But in the present age, humanity do not require those methods anymore. We have come to such a stage as to understand the real meaning of the word responsibility. And the responsibility of living on this earth or killing ourselves lies with us. War or no war depends upon our sense of responsibility. Lord awareness or materialism depends upon our own sense of responsibility. So, the father has given the keys to the children. And it is for the children to use the keys or misuse them. So we stand. No. This is, in short, the history of spiritualism in this humanity. And let us try to understand the word responsibility. And let every one of us behave according to his or her own response. Already we are with the Lord if we do this. Thank you all. Yes, that is the magnitude. There are sub-periods in it. We are in the first sub-period, which is going to end almost with the century. And there will be a re-establishment of the law of the Lord. And there will be a rearrangement of humanity, either after a global war or after a peaceful reconversion of man from war nature to peace nature. The change has to take place in either way. So, one sub-cycle is going to end. No. Spirituality is not at all a religion. It is the science of human being according to which one has to understand his own mechanism and vehicles. And religions are institutions of discipline like schools. Whereas spiritualism is like education, religion is like a school. That's the relationship between a religion and spiritualism. Not mainly, it is the development of awareness of the existence of the Lord in everyone and submitting ourselves to service to humanity in one form or other. And it automatically leads to meditation and God awareness. So, service is the keynote, and the discipline required to live a life of service is one aspect, and meditation is another aspect. Service is the foremost requisite. No age is an age of destruction. The yugas are like seasons. What seasons are in the year, the yugas are in bigger cycles of hundreds and thousands of years. That is all. That is the keynote, and it can be developed through any group that follows the same procedure, that is, serving the humanity. Wherever there is service, it may be in the form of education or medicine or healing, in any one of the essential forms of service, even the people of these professions can do service when their profession is done with a spirit of service. The spirit of commercial relationships will end, and the spirit of mutuality exists, and we begin to exist together on the group level, or what is called the soul consciousness. The soul contact should once again be established among all the humanity. And when that is done, the problems are automatically solved. And that will be done through the spirit of service. Whatever activity or whatever profession we may follow, it is better to make ourselves belong by one of these groups. Which group is not the very important question. What we do and what we want to do and with what spirit we do is the thing that counts. It automatically makes us belong to one group. Yes, that is why the group activity is proposed by the masters. We need not oppose the thought of sects, because by opposing the thoughts of sects, we are giving prominence to the thought form of sects. And once again, we are bringing the idea to the awareness of humanity. So, when we begin to go into a group consciousness and a soul contact, when we begin to live in an affectionate way towards each other, in terms of our daily activity and our professional activity, automatically the sects disappear and group contacts appear. There will be a silent transformation, whereas if we begin to oppose the evil, we will be forced to think of the evil once again. Exactly. We need not destroy any existing structure. For example, the furniture in the hall can be rearranged in a more beautiful way. Instead of condemning the existing furniture and purchasing new furniture. Similarly, the existing structures need not be condemned or opposed. When every one of us begin to approach from another point of view, that is a positive and affectionate point of view, then automatically the structure will have an infrastructure which makes the suprastructure more significant. That is what happens. There are factors from many corners of the earth. Individuals should begin to work in terms of their own activity, and they begin to stand as centers of light, and then there will be a formation of network of individuals into groups, and then there will be a network of groups. Like that, every individual can begin to work from his own place and position and point of view. Only the intention brings the extension. So the masters have taken a path of propagating this idea and bringing this idea to the notice of the humanity and bringing the individuals into this idea and actuating and making them active into this idea, so that the various professions and occupations are molded according to this one idea. Then we will have the manifestation of a power and a light which rearranges the deficient structure, and the establishment of one institution which includes the existing institutions will be the result. It is only for us to have a common intention, and that brings about the change. It is like gathering magnets on the four corners of the globe and charging the iron pieces of the globe. That is how the masters are working for the present. Are the parents happy with their naughty children? This is the same answer. They are happy with us, but they want us to be happy. That's all what they want. They have no second idea about us. They have no complaint against us. They have no fault finding with anyone. How can a fault finding mind be a master? They are all love and affection and nothing else. Those who have a mastery over themselves and those who live among us, they have mastery over their thoughts, their time, their habits and their capabilities. They are called the master. They are simply human beings like us. They want us also masters. So they are not miracles. They are perfect human beings who want us to be perfect also. They are our hope, and they are there to prove the possibility that we can be like them.